Do you agree with Kyle Whittingham? I mean, what else are you going to say? Of course, he's got the best quarterback and the best offensive coordinator combination in the country in his eyes.
Yeah, but Tyler Huntley's a guy that they've invested a lot in, and he's finally got a good game plan around him that's going to maximize his skill set. And Tyler Huntley's best skill set is not his mobility. Tyler Huntley's best skill set is his arm, his ability to throw those deep routes. He can throw the timing routes. He can make all the throws. It doesn't mean you let him throw it 40 times. It doesn't mean you go away from the run game when you're up on Washington State in the second half. I don't know what the thought process was a year ago. Just because Tyler Huntley has a big arm doesn't mean he has to throw it like he's at Washington State.
Bit of a wild pony.
You don't need to throw it every first down. That's not going to help Tyler Huntley's arm. You run it on first down. You let Tyler Huntley on third and five use his legs or his arm to beat you. But no, Troy Taylor's favorite play call was quarterback ISO draw. It's the worst play call in football. Tyler Huntley ran it too many times, but Andy Ludwig really will.
Which is basically just quarterback up the middle.
It's the quarterback, instead of giving the ball to the running back, the quarterback just runs right up the middle. And it's a stupid play for a couple of reasons. One, as an offensive lineman, we don't want anyone other than a running back touching the ball because no one else can do it. All you wide receivers that bitch and moan about wanting the ball, none of you guys are tough enough to run inside. Quarterbacks, same thing. You guys are out there to be protected and get the chicks after the game. Chill out. Give the ball to the running backs. They're human battering rams. So if you're going to run up the gut, do it with a running back. But yeah, the quarterback ISO draw is also a guaranteed way to get your quarterback tackled. Not a good thing if he's 190 pounds and your backup is a freshman like Jason Shelley. And that's what the Utes ran into a year ago. But Andy Ludwig really has changed his offense almost everywhere he's been. It's not like one of these guys, like everybody knew when USC hired Graham Harrell after Cliff Kingsbury went to Arizona that USC was going to run the air raid. Because that's all Graham Harrell does. Like it or not, whatever, that's his system. Andy Ludwig has had eight different systems. When he came to Utah from Oregon, he liked some of the spread concepts, but he said, guys, I'm a pro-style coordinator. So I'm going to add some of your offense that I like. We'll do some up-tempo stuff. We'll do some shotgun snaps. But also we're going to do half-line protection. We're going to do rollouts. We're going to do play-action plays off those rollouts. And it's all going to be tied together to, you know, the base of it is a pro-style offense. And I'll be danged if he didn't adjust it. Because to this day, we still laugh about learning half-line protection. It's what you run so the quarterback can just sort of roll out to his right if he wants to by 10 or 15 yards and make a long throw. So what you do on the front side is you kind of shuffle down and give the quarterback a wall to stand behind. And on the back side, we're talking, let's say you're rolling to your right. So we're talking center, left guard, left tackle. You guys sort of make a J shape. You wheel around almost like the letter U, but there's only three of you. And so the left tackle basically does a back pedal backwards and tries to throw some guy around you because at that point, the quarterback needs to throw it in 5 seconds, but you get like 5 or 6 seconds if you need it. Left guard and the center have to do the same thing. You just basically throw guys to the outside, but it looks weird when you've never run that style of play. And the point is, he taught us a couple of different completely new concepts. He adapted some of our old concepts. And that's the type of coordinator he was, and he'll do the same thing for Utah now. A lot of coordinators show up and they say, here's my system, learn it or get out, and that's not Andy Ludwig.
With Tyler Huntley and a quarterback with his skill set and what we know he can and can't do, do you open up the playbook and let him do a bunch of stuff, or do you really narrow it down to 4 or 5 things that you feel confident that he can do, and you say, if you operate within these parameters, the defense and Zach Moss can do the rest?
There needs to be about 5 plays that the Utes can get up and call every single play. There needs to be a package of plays that Tyler Huntley can just make adjustments off of. And I mean, power, counter, counter, load.
Don't forget counter load.
Sure.
They don't see it coming after all those power counters.
Well, then you hit them with load and they go, wait, that's a completely different motion in the backfield. Wait, there's
power, counter, counter, load.
We got to mix it up. Okay, but there's something to be said in poker. What do you do if you have a full house? You play it. You don't chase the flush. If you've got a good hand, you play it. The Utes have a good running back. It's Zach Moss. Play it. Tell everybody what you have. It's Zach Moss. Lay it out there. And then when everybody is so afraid of Zach Moss and he's on his 12th carry and then he gets his 14th carry and he's averaging 6.5 yards a carry, then you hit him with that play action and they don't know whether to crap or go blind. And that's what a good play call is knowing what your baseline is and then working off of that. And so to bring this thing back to what you asked about Tyler Huntley and what the goal is this year,
The goal is for Tyler Huntley to make 15 of the most comfortable passes he's ever made and then make five really tough ones a game. It is not at all about Tyler Huntley ad-libbing on 20 throws and ad-libbing on 20 runs. It's you got to tell Tyler Huntley what you need him to do, and he will execute it.
You think he can do it?
He will pitch the ball if you need him to. Yeah, because Tyler Huntley deep down wants to win so bad, he's willing to get knocked around by defensive tackles. He doesn't slide because he wants to win. So if you tell him to pitch the ball, he'll do it. If you tell him to throw it, he'll do it. The problem is when you tell Tyler Huntley to make a play, he does. He makes a play by himself. He lowers his shoulder and gets hurt every year. So tell Tyler Huntley how you want to win a game. Show him how, and he can do it. Tyler Huntley can be the second or third best quarterback in the conference. He's going to have some great stats this year. Justin Herbert's going to be pretty dang good. I bet Jacob Eason's going to have some nice games for Washington. You know, Washington State's going to throw it all over the place. And then Tyler Huntley's going to be right there statistically. I bet he'll be top three in the conference.
Can he make those throws that you need him to make? I mean, Yogi Roth says it on every, you know, Pac-12 broadcast he does. He needs his quarterback to be able to make three throws a game. Can he make those three throws? And the best quarterbacks in the world can always make those three throws. You remember the Super Bowl, Tom Brady finds Gronk inside the red zone. Now, Tyler Huntley's not Tom Brady. Can't be fair to expect him to be that. But to be fair, the defenses he's going up against aren't the L.A. Rams either. So can he make the certain throws he needs to against the Pac-12 defenses Utah's going to face?
Look at that throw he made against Stanford. Getting hit, threw a ball 40 yards in the air off his back foot. Few other guys on earth can do that. Being hit or not, just throwing when you're off balance, when you're awkward like that. If you and I did that, that ball would go 18 yards. Tyler Huntley threw it 40 on a frozen rope right to, I believe it was Samson Nakua.
Yep.
That's what you call talent. That's a throw that you can't coach. There's no drill to learn how to do that. So Tyler Huntley can make every throw you need. He's got a big arm. And you saw Jalen Dixon do some of that a year ago, and I think it was pretty clear Jason Shelley was more comfortable with Jalen Dixon than Tyler Huntley was. But why can't Brian Thompson be that guy to take the top off of defense? Tyler Huntley's best ability, though, will be availability. And he's got to remember that. Can't make the club in the tub.